You know Joan Rivers is the star of How'd You Get So Rich, winner of Celebrity Apprentice, and the recently named host of Fashion Police, which will bring her back to E! Entertainment Television. With us tonight, though, for a very different reason. Joan was denied boarding of her commercial flight from Costa Rica to New York on Sunday because of a, quote, suspicious passport. Her passport lists her name as Joan Rosenberg, a.k.a. Joan Rivers. She claims that even after she explained to the gate agent that her married name is Rosenberg, her seat was still given away and she could not fly. All right, you were on vacation, right, in Costa Rica with the family?
Wonderful vacation. We were told to get to the airport in a lot of time because it was already after there was trouble. And we did, and bring all kinds of identification, which we did. And I was taken through four different checkpoints, all of which, glad to do, took off my shoes, take off everything. And then at the last minute, some moron, idiot, decided, as they were literally going to the plane and ripping your ticket, that they didn't understand why my passport had two names on it. And I was denied access to the plane.
Has this ever happened to you flying before?
I've never. I've been all over, Larry. India, China, Nepal, Korea, you name it, Russia.
What?
Never.
What was the gate agent's point of view then? Was it a he or she?
It was a woman, and I think she was premenstrual. And she was just in a terrible... She just wasn't going to understand that I was flying under two names with my passport that the United States government says also known as, a.k.a.
And so you never boarded the plane?
Was not allowed to board the plane, was left in the airport, which closed on Sunday night. It was a very small airport, and was told, that's it. That's it.
We'll have more on this. Hold it, Joan. We'll come right back. More on this in a moment. Joan Rivers, our special guest. Don't go away. 7 Pacific. Back to the dilemma of Joan Rivers. Joan, your passport reads Joan Rosenberg, a.k.a. Joan Rivers. What right. name was on the ticket?
The ticket was Rosenberg, but they had mixed it up, and I didn't see it. I just saw Rosenberg. They put a man's name on, Joseph. So I went through four or five security points where they looked at my passport and didn't notice that it wasn't even my name. So they...
But in these kind of frantic times, do you think maybe the agent, strictly going by the letter of the law, it didn't match?
But, Larry, it should have not matched at the beginning. You don't make me go through the immigration, the customs, the check-in, the seat assignment, and then as you're boarding the plane, they say, wait a second, something's wrong here. That should have been told to me 2.5 hours before I arrived, when I first arrived at the airport.
They didn't know you in Costa Rica? The agent didn't know who you were?
No. All the people in line knew me and were asking for autographs and taking pictures. At one point, I got so frustrated, I said, get the pilot. Call the pilot. He will know me. Uh-huh. They refused to do that. I said, call the airline in New York City. They refused to do it.
Did the rest of your family fly home?
They had flown home half an hour ahead of me. So I was totally alone.
Joan, we spoke to Continental Airlines about what happened and were told they provide names and information to the local immigration authority, and if there's a discrepancy with a name on their passenger list, they may have to hold someone from boarding.
Absolutely fine, Larry. Absolutely fine. But they should have told me that when I checked in. And don't tell me I'm Joseph Rosenberg, and then when I get to the gate, they suddenly say, oh, wait a second, this is wrong. I had my ticket, I had my boarding pass, I had gone, as I said, through all immigration and customs. This is nonsense. And how dare they? How dare they? I find this
outrageous. All right, now what happened after? The plane takes off, you're at the little airport.
The plane took off, and I was told, I said, well, what do I do? I had $100. I'd given Melissa all my money because she was going to change Atlanta. I said, you'll need tip money. I had $100 and nothing in the middle of nowhere in an airport that was an hour and a half from the hotel. I said, what do I do? And they said, they closed the airport on Sunday night. They said, maybe we can get you on a plane on Friday. How about that one? Luckily, the man who was, I had one man with me who was pushing my luggage, and out of the kindness of his heart, this man named Elton, he started getting me phone numbers, and he went in the back, and he said, if you drive to San Jose, there's another airport there. So I drove for 6.5 hours at night in a car with a man I didn't know over back roads and got myself to San Jose. It was.
And what happened at the airport there?
The airport there, the next morning, Continental had a wonderful man named Joe Arenzik, who from 4 o'clock on was on the phone with me. But they had sent to Houston. Even that got screwed up. But finally,
they allowed you to get on with the name differential from the ticket, or did they screw that whole thing up?
Of course. If it's good enough for Russia and Nepal and China and Japan and Korea and everywhere else I've been, I think it should be good enough for Costa Rica. It was just...
We'll ask Joan in a minute if she throws it up to the nature of the times right after this. Joan, a couple of things in this incredibly puzzling story. Who was the guy who drove you 6.5 hours on back roads?
I don't know his name, and he was a lovely man. And I'm sorry, as I said, the man named Elton helped me in Liberia, and a lady named Cindy helped me in San Jose. And the other gentleman, I got his card, and then in my hysteria, lost it.
Well, he just said, I'm driving to this airport, I'll give you
a
lift.
He said, this man, Elton, arranged for it. And got me in that.
Was it true that when you were in your anger, you told the gate agent you were having a heart attack?
No.
You called the paramedics?
Yeah, what it was, again, it was about rich tourists, Larry. They didn't know who I was. And I said to her, you must be kidding. I'm going to have a heart attack over this. And the woman said, click, woman having a heart attack. Let's get the paramedics. And they brought them in.
Frankly, Joan, do you think this is the nature of the times? It's just what the world is now.
Okay, let me just tell you, and it's a joke, but it's not a joke, that we can have a couple break into the White House, and they're not arrested? I find this outrageous. First time in our history that a white couple, my joke is, broke into a black man's house, and that ha, 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 but it's not funny. It's serious times,
no.
And let's take them seriously, and let's be careful. But they handed
me a quick call in. Reading, Pennsylvania, hello.
Joan, don't you feel ashamed of yourself that you're calling a poor woman that's just doing her job the way the federal guidelines are set up and calling her a moron?
I mean, no, I don't, my darling. Just hold it, mister. I was given a boarding pass with the wrong name on it. I went through 5 different security passes, and then a woman at the gate who will not look at my passport, who will not call Continental, who will not call for help, who will not recheck into their records, says to me, you cannot go on? No. She is a moron. And I stand corrected. And this should happen to you.
Sorry, we're out of time.
Okay. Don't you tell me that.
By the way, to find out where Joan's appearing next, including her QVC dates this weekend, go to our website, cnn.com/Larry King. And congratulations on 20 years at QVC.
Thank you,
Thanks,
my darling.
Joan.